Welcome back to Philadelphia, everybody, at ABC's continuing coverage of the 98 State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships, the Championship Dance. Two of these fine teams will make the United States Olympic team. And you talk about one city being represented here, Terry. Those top five teams, all five, train in Detroit. The Motown Five coming your way, partner.
Motown in Philly, I guess, Brent. But I'll tell you, change happens in the world of ice dancing about as often as the Cubs make it to the World Series. But we've had plenty of it this week in Philadelphia. And, Dick, if you're looking for not only great skating but compelling stories, we've got them for you here in the free dance.
Well, you know, this should be kind of be a humdinger of a championship. Mm-hmm. I mean, just consider the following points. Of the top five skaters, all of them are coached by the same team. Igor Spielbond of Russia, Elizabeth Coates of Great Britain. Number two, two of the top five pairs, if they win here, will not be able to go on to the Olympics. They've got citizenship problems. Number three, even if the favorite ice dancers here, Punsalan and Swallow, win, the program that you see will not be the program they will skate at the Olympics. And four, everybody knows that ice rankings change, I mean, in ice dancing with the speed of a glacier, and that yet we have here a very young couple who are in the senior championships for their first time, and they are poised to make the Olympic team. You will understand why just as soon as you see their speed and the flow and the way they mesh.
And the other team that no doubt will go to Nagano on the Olympic team, Liz Punsalan and Jared Swallow, the four-time U.S. champions. There they are backstage making last-minute preparations. Husband and wife, kindred spirits. Their skating reflects their life together. Brent Musburger takes a closer look.
I could dance nightly just holding you tightly, my sweet.
They are two halves of a whole, hand in hand, joined by mind and by heart. Everything they share is with them on the ice, and they have been by each other's side through it all.
The time that we notice it the most, when we notice how much we're with each other, is when we're away from each other. And it doesn't happen very often, but we really function as one person, the two of us. And it's more strange for us to be apart than it is for us to be together.
Success came quickly. In 1991, Elizabeth and Jared claimed the national title in only their second season as a team.
Ladies and gentlemen,
that victory transformed them into favorites for a berth on the 92 Olympic team. But they fell in the free dance at the Nationals and failed to make the team. That disappointment was nothing compared with what they confronted in 94. Punsalan and Swallow captured the national title in their hometown of Detroit to earn a trip to Lillehammer. But that elation turned to heartache when Elizabeth's father was murdered by her brother just days before their scheduled departure for the Olympics. They skated, but it was a horribly difficult time.
The last Olympics, we were kind of, we came in late, we did what we needed to do, and we left early. Obviously, there were distractions, personal distractions.
Tragedy such as that might have destroyed other skaters, but the love and understanding that Elizabeth and Jared have developed over 4 years of marriage carries them through both good and bad. It's a connection that other ice dancers can only pretend to have.
We're very comfortable with one another and the emotions that we need to use towards one another. Some people want to keep these emotions to themselves. You actually are giving a piece of your privacy or your private life to the audience, or you're giving it away in your performance.
I think that is part of what sets Jared and I apart from some of the other couples, is that we are comfortable with each other and we do have a relationship, and whether we're trying to portray that or not, it's just there.
The Russian dominance on the world of ice dancing is legendary. But with a sixth-place finish at last year's Worlds, Punsalan and Swallow are establishing themselves.
I believe that the future of ice dance for the Americans is looking up, and it may not be our time or our place to be able to break through, but I do believe in the future that it'll happen.
Liz and I definitely want to be remembered as an ice dance couple from the United States that really brought or started the pendulum swinging in the right direction.
And there they are on the ice warming up for this championship free skate. Their last year as eligible competitors. They would love to finish into the top five or even medal at the Olympics, but they definitely want to send themselves out with a win here at the national championships. Well, they have paved the way for other young couples. We mentioned earlier the team that has really caused a stir all week here in Philadelphia, Jessica Joseph and Charlie Butler, in their first year as senior competitors in second place and perhaps going to the Olympic Games. Leslie Visser has more right now.
Terry, the unusual scenario where Igor Spielbon and Liz coach all the top teams has been an enormous benefit to Joseph M. Butler. When Igor Spielbon defected from Russia 8 years ago, he had nothing more to his name than a pair of skates over his shoulder. But the first team he coached was Joseph M. Butler. They talked about their remarkable rise.
Well, the whole competition throughout every day was extremely close and extremely pressured. And, I mean, you had to calm your nerves every minute of every second of every day, you know. It was really tough. But I guess we both sort of stuck together and skated through it. It was exciting.
I think that Junior Worlds was really exciting. And it worked well for us because in tough competitions, we tend to rise to the occasion as opposed to, you know, skate not so well because of we're nervous or anything else. We seem to take that nervous environment and use it, you know, to our benefit.
And they were the first team from America to win any world title in ice dancing when they recently won the junior world title, skyrocketing up the ladder, and that just does not happen in the world of ice dancing.
Couples, there is 1 minute remaining in this one.
So they're in second place after the original dance with a real chance of staying there and going to the Olympics. In fact, the odds are in their favorite. Well, here's the skate order for the championship free dance. Shalom and Gates. Eve Shalom, Matthew Gates in fourth place. They will skate first. Then the four-time champions, Punzelin and Swallow, followed by Lang and Chernichev, and down the line. And Dick, you mentioned that there are some eligibility problems here because there are skaters who are not yet U.S. citizens, and certainly that will come into play with our first team, Eve Shalom and Matthew Gates.
Well, Matthew Gates is British and doesn't have citizenship, and the rules state very simply that you cannot compete on the American Olympic team unless you are an American citizen. So that knocks that couple out. Secondly of all, Lang and Chernichev are also knocked out because Chernichev is also Russian, will not have his citizenship for this games, but will probably for the next Olympic games. It clearly is a leveling factor.
But you are eligible for the World Championships, so that is also a factor here. Eve Shalom, Matthew Gates, there you look. Debbie Cagle and Oleg Fedyukov also in this competition. They were not eligible for the Olympics. And Naomi Lang and Peter Chernichev also, we mentioned, but again, you are eligible for the World Championships. So, for example, Eve Shalom and Matthew Gates in fourth place after the original dance. They may not be able to go to the Olympics, but if they move up, the selection committee could send them to the world.
Remember, what we're seeing here is ice dancing, not pair skating. The purpose of all of this is to perform a dance. Athletic, dynamic highlights that don't enhance the character of this dance are not supposed to be rewarded, even though they may be spectacular. This is pure ice dancing.
Shalom and Gates, the junior national champions in 1995. They captured a silver medal at the senior nationals a year ago.
One of the most important decisions you can make as an ice dancer is the choice of music. This is King Porter's Song by Miller Crossing. Now, what watch carefully and you'll see how strong these skaters are. There's a very solid edge to them. They also have almost a frantic quality with the exceptional number of moves and positions that they achieve. This slower part of the music, Black and Blue Fantasy. These movements, very nice, but not as fine as they could be. Remember, these couples will be competing against some very powerful Russian skaters if they make it to the Olympics.
Eligible for the World Championships, not the Olympics. But Matthew Gates, having grown up in Great Britain, Dick, has always idolized Christopher Dean, and he had a chance to work with him over the summer a little bit. Do you see any influence at all?
Absolutely. There's a great Christopher Dean influence on his skating. It's quite different from the so-called Russian style of ice dancing.
Long, and it's worth 50% of the overall score.
Now, this third part of the program is Got My Own Thing Now. A very big band sound to this program. These movements, very busy. Doesn't seem to look like as beautiful ice dancing as it could. The meshing together of this couple, not as sophisticated as some of the others. They certainly are strong and powerful, though. A very good program.
Well, they were disappointed after the original dance because a year ago they captured the silver medal, but they were in fourth place when they took the ice here today.
Well, I think one of the problems is that they haven't really grown since last year.
Eve Shalom and Matthew Gates, and getting ready to take the ice next, the four-time U.S. champions, going after number five, Punchlin and Swallow, when we return.
America's top skaters are jumping into history. You can be a part of the team when you join the official USA Figure Skating Team Fan Club. Call 1-800-363-8796 and you'll receive this exclusive team tote bag available only to club members. You'll also receive this limited edition team pin, official team photo, and biannual newsletter. Plus, a spectacular 90-minute video, Magic Memories on Ice 3, an unforgettable season. Call 1-800-363-8796 for your one-year membership. $15 plus $4.95 shipping.
Eve Shalom, Matthew Gates in fourth place after the original dance and the first set of marks for technical merit.
Now look at those, the level of those. They're very good and they deserve to be. That was a very solid performance. Look at this as they do a reverse step through. Watch now. First of all, the lean and the edge right there. She'll grab his ankle, swing herself through, going forward, which is very hard, and move right up.
You talk to many judges, and they say this discipline is maybe the hardest to judge because there are no obvious mistakes out there for the most part.
What I've said many a times is there's none of the big bow-wow here that they can hide behind. There's no triple jumps. There's no dazzling throws. There's no spin, and that makes it very tough. I mean, it's pure skating. Remember, the restrictions that they have here
They're
are just extraordinary.
Music selections entitled Brave Combo.
So here are the leaders after the original dance. They have won four national championships. Their first in 1991, another one in 94, and in the last 2 years, trying to become the first to win five since Michael Stewart and Judy Blumberg in the early 80s. Elizabeth Punslin and Jarrett Swallow.
Now, one of the things you want to see here is their flight across the ice, the speed that they have. Now, watch this sequence. The reverse edging, that beautiful lift. The swing, the load. A very, very well-meshed step. Look at this long, low edge. One of the things that you notice here is the way they progress from straight up, middle level, down to low edging. Great variety.
Well, it was a sixth place finish at the Champion Series final that sent Punslin and Swallow back to work, redesigning a new free dance for the Olympics. This is not it here. Wonder how smart that is at this point.
You know, in ice dancing, you're either in or you're out. People are either talking about you or they're not. The fact that they haven't progressed to new programs, I think, hurt them a little bit. At any rate, they were not talked about so much at the recent Champion Series final, so they didn't feel that there was excitement about them. Look at these beautiful swinging edges. One of the important things is deep loads, strong edges, great curves. That's wonderful. This, one of the great stretches, pointed toes, stretched lines. In all of skating.
Their style has really changed over the years too, hasn't it? And has reflected their relationship. Remember early on, a race car theme to one of their programs, an Olympic theme. Most are romantic now.
I think those were attempts to perform theme dances, which really and generally are frowned upon in the world of ice dancing. One of the things that you notice here are variations both in tempo and movement and in speed. And that's very important to show the variety of steps and dances that there are. Very important also that skaters skate facing each other in addition to being side by side. Look at this hair spread eagle. Very minimal. I just think 1 second off at the end, but you can forgive them easily because that's such a number, that's a powerful number.
And they share their success and failures, of course, together away from the ice, too. A married couple, Igor Spielbon, Elizabeth Coates.
Elizabeth Coates, right.
Who do you cheer for? You've got all five of the top teams in this competition. We'll have Punxsutawney and Swallows marks when we return to Philadelphia. Back in Philadelphia, Liz Punxsutawney and Jarrett Swallow following their championship three dance.
5.8.
And the marks for technical merit, 5.7 up to 5.9. The leaders after the original dance and expected to win this competition.
Well, take a look at this particular move. Now, this is one of the really great moves of ice dancing. Look at the stretch and the line and the lowness of it all. That gives variety to other moves which are middle or high. But that stretch, the turnout of the foot, is really beautiful.
Well, they became partners in 89, won their first national championship 2 years later in 91, the first of four in what will become now five. 5.8s and 5.9s for presentation for Liz Punxsutawney and Jarrett Swallow.
Very solid.
Should be on their way to the Olympics as the national champions.
And deservedly so.
Representing the Detroit City Club, let's welcome Naomi Lang and Peter Chernyshev.
But here's the couple in third place after the original dance. Naomi Lang, Peter Chernyshev. Remember, they are not eligible for the Olympic Games, but can go to the World Championships if the International Committee decides that they should be on that team. So what they do here in Philadelphia means more than just pride and medals. Shalom and Gates in the same situation. They're in second place right now overall. Different situation for these two than most of the foreign teams, as it were. Most of the time, it's the woman in America who is looking for a male partner to dance with. In this situation, it's Peter who went looking and found Naomi. And another one, of course, of the teams coached by Igor Spielbon and Elizabeth Coates.
Now look at those steps. He is a brilliant skater. He's had a habit in the past of falling a lot, but I can tell you something, he's probably one of the most wonderful ice dancers in the world of ice dancing. Edges. One of the requirements of ice dancing. Lows, deep edges, deep lean of the body.
With all of these teams being coached by Spielbon and Coates, you see a lot of similarities or
somewhat.
Yeah?
Somewhat, yeah. Now look at this straight line sequence of steps. Watch how they skate face to face as well as side by side. That's considered to be the most difficult part of ice dancing. Many of the pupils of Igor Spielbon seem to favor Latin types of dance, rhythms. We see that in this couple. One of the reasons being is that the ISU insists
that you have a beat to your music. No dancing with no beat. Oh, a little problem there, it seemed as though. Beautiful position. I must say they're a very effective pair. He supports her and presents her beautifully.
Naomi Lang, Peter Chernyshev in their second effort at the Senior Nationals. We'll have their marks and the performance of Jessica Joseph and Charlie Butler, the talk of the ice dancing competition, when we come back. But first, to Robin Roberts in New York. If you're watching now, I know you're going to be with us tonight. Tara Lipinski trying to come back against Michelle Kwan and the rest of the ladies. The State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships, 8 o'clock Eastern Time, right here at the CoreStates Center. The Olympic team will be named, medals handed out. Well, the free dance continuing, Naomi Lang and Peter Chernyshev. The technical merit marks, 5.3 up to 5.6.
5.4. And look at this, first a lift, beautiful position. Just beautiful, but she seems to get around just a little bit too far right here, doesn't keep on skating and slips off. Now that's a very minor mistake, but in ice dancing, minor mistakes are big.
In third place after the original dance, looking to move up, the marks for presentation, there they are, and Lang and Chernyshev do move up into second place, right in back of Punzelin and Swallow, and ahead of Shalom and Gates.
And one really severe deduction from one of the judges for that slip.
We're skating to several music selections performed by Gypsy Kings. Representing the Detroit Skating Club, how about a warm welcome for Jessica Joseph and Charles Butler.
The junior national champions, the junior world champions, trying to make the Olympic team in their first try here at Nationals that has never been done before. Joseph and Butler.
Don't watch only the feet. Look at what's happening, the stuff that's happening up above. That's sensational. Beautiful intermeshing of arms and position. A lot of skating face to face. Deep edges here. Wonderful changes of position, changes of direction.
Junior level to where they are right now is amazing enough, but also when you consider that Charlie sprained his left ankle 3 weeks ago, they were off the ice for 2.5 weeks and only practiced for 5 days coming into these championships. It's more amazing. The first team that Igor Spielman coached.
Beautiful position, gorgeous legs, great turnout. An interesting pace where he's low and she is not.
wonderful examples of middle, high, and low positions on the ice. That's a magnificent swinging move, turning and changing. It fits all the rules of ice dancing. Sensational for such a young couple with such little top-level experience.
Jessica, 15 years of age, and Charlie, 18 years old, the first team coach by Igor Spielbon. Their first trip. There are their parents, Charles Butler, Joyce, and Jim Joseph. I'd say they're proud parents, huh?
Well, it's a very interesting young pair. Very interesting.
Jared Swallow, who, of course, practices on the same ice as they do back in Detroit. Detroit well represented here. Joseph and Butler's marks in a moment.
You're watching the State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships on ABC Sports.
We are back at the CoreStates Center in Philadelphia. Jessica Joseph, Charles Butler, the technical merit marks. Remember, they were in second place, hoping to at least stay there.
Now, look at this lift. The good stretch of it, the way she moves around, the change of edge. The position. Remember, those lifts are so controlled that the rule book is an inch thick just talking about what you can't do in a lift.
And now the marks for presentation.
Very consistent and very steady. 5.6s and 5.7s.
Yeah, the range 5.4 all the way up to a 5.7. But those are good enough, Dick, to put them in second place ahead of Lang and Chernyshev.
Interesting, interesting. Uh-huh.
So it's Punsalem and Swallow, Joseph and Butler, then Lang and Chernyshev.
And still to come, Kate Robinson, Peter Breen,
who are in fifth place after the original dance.
We're skating to several music selections entitled Slow Walk, Lafayette, and Shake 'Em Up. She represents the Detroit Skating Club, and he the Broadmoor Skating Club. Let's welcome now Kate Robinson and Peter Breen.
And this has really been a disappointing national championship so far for Robinson and Breen. They were the bronze medalists last year in Nashville. So they'd like to move up here, but so far it hasn't gone their way.
This is a much simpler dance, a much simpler style of ice dancing. It gives you time to breathe and see some of the moves. But it is not as intricate and not as good if he's going to stumble like that as some of the other dancers. In these lifts, the man cannot lift her with his hands above his shoulders. He also can't rotate more than 1.5 times. He can't let her sit on his shoulders or sit, not sit there. He can't do more than 5 minutes in duration of any lift, and he can't display a feat of strength or acrobatics. And I've got 100 other rules I can read two for you if you'd like to hear them all.
In other words, it's not pair skating.
It is
ice dancing.
The rules of ice dancing are thicker than all the other disciplines of skating put together.
But you've said often that in many ways it exemplifies the the best that skating has to offer. You don't concentrate on all those jumps. It's edging and how you move across the ice.
That's the way it's supposed to be. But the rules that govern this are just incredibly complicated.
Again, Robinson and Breen in fifth place heading into this program. Liz Punchlin and Jared Swallow in the lead, looking to grab their fifth national championship.
And I think she has great flight on the ice. Very nice speed. Long legs, good stretch, good turnout.
The question that remains here in the ice dancing, whether Joseph and Butler can hang on to second place in their first trip to the Senior Nationals, coming off a Junior World title.
Nowhere near as intricate or as difficult as some of the other programs that we've seen so far. But somehow the program didn't seem to build as well as it should have. It took off strong and then it kind of settled down. It didn't have the theatrical beginning, middle, and an end that any theatrical piece should have.
We'll have to wait and see where Kate Robinson and Peter Breen end up. They were in fifth place. Punchlin and Swallow in first place, looking to win their first championship. On their way to number five. And Joseph and Butler, will they finish second and go to the Olympic Games? We'll find out when we come back to Philadelphia. America's premier extreme sports extravaganza. That's what they call it, folks. It's back on ESPN from Crested Butte, Colorado. The Winter X Games. Coverage begins Friday at 8:30 Eastern, 5:30 Pacific. Snowboarding events, ice climbing events. They've got it all on ESPN. Beginning Friday at 8:30 Eastern. So, Kate Robinson, Peter Breen, the final dance couple.
Those marks clearly will not bring them up high enough to challenge either Punchlin, Swallow, or Joseph and Butler.
No, they were in fifth place, and those are nowhere near as high as those of the leaders. Remember, unofficially, you can normally assume in this event that the top two teams will go to the Olympics, but it is an international committee who decides that second spot, and they will name them. The winners automatically go. And the marks for presentation, 5.4. up to 5.6. So Robinson and Breen stay in fifth place. And guess what? It's Elizabeth Punchlin and Jared Swallow who win national championship number five. And right next to them, well, they've been amazing people all week. Joseph and Butler. What a team that is going to be over the next 4 or 5 years. And I guess unofficially you can say those are the two teams that will be going to the Olympic Games. Here's how they end up. The championship three dance. Punchlin and Swallow again win. Third year in a row. Jessica Joseph, Charlie Butler, first year as seniors, finished with the silver medal. Lang and Chernyshev and Shalom and Gates. You'll have to wait and see. Perhaps one of those teams will go to the World Championships. Right now, Leslie Visser is with some very happy people. Leslie?
Well, they're just settling in. We have the whole spectrum of ice dancing right here on this bench. We have in their first national championships, in their last national championships. Congratulations. Jessica, first to you. What attitude did you come here with today?
We came here to come and skate our best, and it was up to the judges to do the rest, but we just wanted to show the crowd a good time.
Charlie, did you ever let yourself dream of making the Olympic team?
I wasn't planning on it in 1998.
You might have to get used to it. And congratulations, your fifth title. Jared, what makes this one different?
I think being an Olympic year, you get all nostalgic thinking about your previous championships. And 4 years ago, we won at home in Detroit, and it's a lot of emotion involved there. And anytime you make an Olympic team, it's very emotional. We couldn't be happier. And five titles, it's great.
Your free skate is so beautiful. Why are you changing it for the Olympics?
Well. Good question. Liz, you want to take that?
Yeah, we'd like to try to bring up our artistic mark a little more, and we think a tango would be a great venue for us to do so.
Yeah, that's right. You guys are beautiful in the tango. What about for you in your last Olympics? It was a lot of pain going into the Olympics. You lost your father. What kind of joy or attitude will you take to this one?
Well, I think this Olympics we're definitely going to celebrate to the fullest and just enjoy each other and our skating.
Well, it shows. You've all been a joy to watch, and best of luck to all of you. To you, Brent.
Leslie, thank you very much, and congratulations to our champions, and good luck to both of those fine teams over in Japan. We'll show you more of our competitors heading for Japan tonight when we show you how the pairs competition wound up. And then, of course, if you want to call it the heavyweight championship of these competition, the ladies' final, four outstanding skaters, the depth of the United States talent. And remember, only three of them can make it to the United States Olympic team. So which three of these four wonderful skaters will it be? The elegant Michelle Kwan. She delighted and thrilled everyone with her short program. Right behind her in second place is Nicole Bobic. Unpredictable. Tanya Kwiatkowski, third and very steady. And then, of course, Tara Lipinski, a disappointed fourth, but determined. That's tonight at 8 Eastern. Robin Roberts will be coming back from New York after these commercial messages.